What's going on, everyone? Welcome to the shop. We're going to be working on a small project to dip my toes into this content stuff. My goal is to make some cool projects that I think people will like, as well as try to show and teach the way that I do things. I usually have an end game of how I want things to look, but no clear-cut way of how I'm going to get to that end game. This project is a plaque for my son's Boy Scout troop while they are at camp. It's going to be cut on the CNC and then filled with epoxy resin. When it's done, it will be brought to the camp for the boys to sign so they can have a troop keepsake from camp this year. If you like what you see and want to see the next projects I have in mind, hit the like, the subscribe, and smash that notification button. Now, let's get out to the wood shop and start winging this project.
I have this poplar left over from a different project. I'm going to measure it up, cut it, and then flip the table around so I can use the planer to plane it down to size. As you can see, I'm an idiot and I forgot to hook up the dust extraction, so I'm making a mess everywhere. Got the piece on the CNC and we're gonna watch it do its thing. I have to hand vacuum as it's going because my dust extraction on this is set up for my old setup and I haven't had a chance to remake a new one. Thank you. And as you can see, I'm making a small mess again. This step right here wasn't necessary for this project, but it's good to get in the habit. I'm siliconing around the areas for the epoxy. This way I'm making a dam so that the colors don't bleed into each other. On smaller projects, this is very crucial. You don't want your colors bleeding and making colors you don't want. And now it's time to mix up some epoxy. I use this super clear by FGCI. It's food safe for when I do cutting boards and charcuterie boards. It's great. The only downfall is this is only made for 1/4 inch pours. So if you need to do something deeper, you'd have to go to a deep pour resin. Right now, I'm just going to be doing clear to do a base coat, so the epoxy doesn't bleed into the wood. As you can see, the seal coat is down to prevent the wood from epoxy bleeding. This project has 5 different colors that I'm going to mix up: black, red, blue, green, and orange. I went a little overboard with the pouring. I made a little too much epoxy, especially the blue, but it's not a big deal. It's gonna get machined down anyway. And we're back on the CNC. I have a 2-inch facing bit in the machine. This thing makes easy work of this type of stuff. Speaking of sanding, I'm going to hit this very lightly with some 120, then some 220, and then finally finish it off with some 320. Then I'm going to do a 1/4-inch round over on the edge. I had all the boys sign it, and that's the finished product. I hope you all enjoy it. Thanks for watching.